Good day, we'll continue with the instruction set of the floating point processor. So there are many type of instructions available. However, we concentrate on three major important instruction. So add or subtract or multiply instruction, add dot L1, A3, A7, comma A7, which adds A3 and A7, and the resultant is stored in the A7, or we can tell that it is accumulated and the accumulator value is stored in A7. The unit dot L1 is optional. So we have seen that among the 8 functional units, that L unit which writes to register A, it is used for addition operation. So we can tell which unit to be used, it is optional. If the destination or the result is in B7, the unit would be in L2. So the instruction sub dot S1. A1, 1, A1. So it subtracts 1 from A1 and the resultant is stored in A1. And this operation, subtraction operation, is being done by means of S1 unit. The next parallel instructions. So parallel MPY A7 B7. So it multiplies 16 LSBs of A7 B7 and the resultant is stored in B6. In parallel, so it implies MPYH implies that it multiplies higher order bits of A7, B7 and stores it in A6. So multiplies 16 bits and places in B6 in parallel concurrently with the second instruction that multiplies higher of A7 and B7 and places the result in A6. In this fashion, so if we implement an instruction in this fashion, two multiply accumulate operations can be executed within a single instruction cycle, and this will produce so on so that it will be very convenient to implement an FIR filter MAC operation. The next instruction is load or store instruction. So as it implies, LDH loads into B7. So load B7, the half word of 16 bits whose address in memory is specified or pointed by B2. So that is pointed by B2. The register B2 is incremented to point to the next highest next memory address, B2 plus 1. In parallel is another indirect addressing mode instruction to load into A7 the content in memory. So that memory content is specified by this A2 pointer. So the A2 is incremented to point at the next higher memory address, A2 plus 1. So the instruction LDW, so is loads a 32-bit word, and this is in parallel with another load instruction. So two dot D are the functional units that are used for loading and storing operations. So using LWB instruction, two paths D1 and D2 allow for loading of data from memory to register A and B using the instruction LDW. Similarly, we have an instruction STW which stores data. So STW dot D2. So the functional unit used is D2, A1 comma plus A4 of 20. So initially, A4 is pre-incremented by 20, and that incremented value is moved on or stored in this location A1. So, to the new memory location, the 32-bit A1 is moved on. So, this stores the 32-bit word A1 into the memory address whose address is specified by A4 shifted by or offset by 20 words. The address register A4 is pre-incremented with offset, but it is not modified. The next common instruction is branch or move. So this segment shows how branching operation is done. So using MVK, MVKH. So the first instruction moves. We can see that MVK is for lower order and H is for higher order. The first instruction moves the lower order bits of address X into the register A4. and then the second instruction moves the higher order 16 bits of address X into A4, which now contains, so now finally A4 contains the full 32 bit address of X. The instruction MVK bar MVK is used in order to get a 32 bit constant into a register. So register A1 is used as a loop counter. So a further number of operations are being done, and after it is decremented with, when we see a subtract operation, so A1 is subtracted by 1 and the resultant is again stored in A1. It is, after it is decremented with subtract, it is tested for a conditional branch. So the conditional branch operation uses dot S2. Execution branches to the label or address loop if A1 is not equal to 0. If A1 is equal to 0, execution continues and data in register A3 are stored in the memory whose address is pointed by A7. So it branches to loop if A1 is not equal to 0. So once, so this loop is in, decremented again and again until A1 becomes 0. So once it becomes 0, we just perform 5 no operation and the final value in A3 is moved and stored on to the memory location pointed by A7. Thank you.